is Philips patient monitor MX430 model. So this is the backside connection. Here is the power cord connection. Here you can see LAN connection so that you can connect your central monitor LAN cable over here. This is DVI slot. This is for mirroring your patient monitor display to other monitor. Then this is your USB port from where you can get your event history data. Then these three slots are for future upgradation. So this is your MMS server. MMS is your multi-measurement server. Here are a few shortcut keys. You can silence alarms from this MMS server as well. Then you can start stop your NIVP, and then for zeroing pressure, you can press this key. Here are few basic parameters. That's why it is called as basic server. Your ECG, NIVP, SpO2, pressure and temperature. This is extension server. You can see gray connector over here. Here your MMS server will get connected. That is your basic server will get connected. Here you can see one gray button over here, which is used to disconnect your basic MMS server with your extension server. There are many types of extension server. For example, various other slots will be there. So here I am using one of them. Pressure connection, temperature, and for CO2, that is your ETCO2. So now we will see how to connect your basic MMS server with the extension server. You can see gray connector and also this gray. You have to match this gray, and also I'll connect in this slot with this slot. Next, press this and this one. Here both servers are connected. You can see this gray slot with this gray slot. This port with this port. While removing this server, you have to hold server like this to avoid damages. You can see one button over here. Hold, press, and remove. So now moving towards side connections. Here is your battery. Inserting, this should be up. Yes, and then battery. You can see the battery percentage, that is 100, 75, 50, 25. You can see push written over here. Press this button. So my battery is 25% charged. So now front connections. Here is the on-off switch. These are the alarm indicators. There are three colors in alarms. Blue, that is your technical alarm. Yellow, mid priority alarm, that is clinical alarm only. And red, that is high priority alarm. So, once the monitor is on, you can see my servers got detected. My MMS server and extension server. So, this monitor is touchscreen. So, starting with the top area, here you can see the bed label. Here you can admit your patient. Enter the details. First name, MRN. Number of the patient. Rest all details you can enter. Once it is entered, confirm. So your patient name and all details will come over here. You can select the profile from here as well or from here also. Profile, that is the category of patient. adult, pediatric, neonate. Accordingly, you can select. Once selected, you see here also adult, pediatric, and neonate. Once patient is admitted, for now I have kept my monitor in demo mode. This is the layout of the screen. This is the dynamic wave. If I select overlapping, the layout will change. Same for others. If I want big numbers, only 12-lead ECG. So accordingly, you can set your screen layout. And this is the alarm sound. You can set the volume of your alarm from here. So these are the waveforms. If you want to change the upper and lower limit of any parameter, then you can change from here. This is the upper limit and this is the lower limit. If your patient's data or parameter goes above 120, then it will give alarm. Or below this, then it will give alarm. So, if you want to change it, you can change over here. You can see it is changed. If you want to change the lead from lead 1 to lead 3, so lead 3. Now, this is the lower part of the screen. This is to silence the alarm. This is to pause your alarm for 2 minutes. This is start stop of your NIBP. If you want to stop all the parameters reading at a time, you can stop from this, stop all. Zeroing of the ETCO2 can be done over here or arterial line. Then screen recording. You can set up over here. Once done, if you don't know where to go, you can press main screen. Then trends. Trends are basically the details of the patient. You can see the time. You can also see the graph trend. You can change the interval. 1 hour 15 minutes accordingly, and then close. Patient demographics, you can admit patient from here as well or from here as well, and then monitor standby. Come back to the screen. This double arrow will show the further data. This start statics is for your NIBP start stop. This is the alarm volume. You can change from here as well or from here also. Once set, then graph trend, calculations. If any calculation you want to do, you can calculate according to the height and weight of the patient. Then once you press the end case, your patient will automatically get discharged from this monitor. These 4 keys are fixed. These 2 and these 2. So if you want to change this area, you can press this double arrow. Then this looks like your server. So if you want to disable any parameter, so for now, I want to disable my CO2, so deactivate. So my CO2 waveform will go. Again, if I want to activate, can activate from here. So my CO2 waveform will come. From here also, you can see the battery status. My battery is not charged right now. So it is showing battery empty alarm. This is the LAN symbol. You can see this upper portion is filled and the downside portion is empty. This means this monitor is connected to the central monitor. If I disconnect my line cable, it will start blinking, which means it is not connected to the central monitor. Again, insert it. So now it is filled, which means it is connected to the central monitor. Also, sometimes this symbol is stable, but the upper portion is not filled, which means that there is network issue. So it should be always filled. You can see the bed numbers in the top area. This blue indicates that this monitor is not connected to the central monitor. This is the bed level, so it would be in this color, which means it is connected to the central monitor.